call the meeting to order. It's 10 o'clock. We'll have roll call. We'll start with Jean.
Jean Sous.
Bob Brown.
Joyce Plant.
Doris Wassilowski.
Joan Grigham.
Minyan Murray.
Brenda Hackett.
Lillian Halpin.
Cheryl Westman.
Karen Sheehan.
Mary Clark.
Can we also have a moment of silence for those people that were murdered in California? Thank you. We have a citizen here. Do you have a comment? No? Okay.
Silence.
Communication. None? Don't get that. Okay, minutes. I need a motion to accept.
The minutes are not right on the old time. Joan is in place and I'm not in at all and I was here last week.
Say that again.
In the minutes from last month, Joan is in place.
Yep.
And I'm not in at all and I was here.
I'm sorry.
That's okay.
I'm a little bit confused here. What can I do?
At the roll call.
Joan was not here and you were?
Joan was here, but you've got her in place.
She got her name in place.
Oh.
And you don't have me in at all.
Oh, jeez. Okay, thank you.
All right.
Other than that, are there any other comments or corrections? I need a motion to accept.
I make a motion.
I need a second.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Thank you. Director's report.
Good morning, everyone.
Morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
I have a couple of updates on staffing. As we have discussed, we're hiring a second outreach worker. So we have one outreach worker right now who's 15 hours, and we're hiring a second outreach worker who will also be 15 hours. So Cheryl and I were interviewing all day yesterday. We interviewed someone last week. We have one more this afternoon. So within the next few weeks, we'll narrow down our pool. We had a range of applicants with different skill sets, so we're confident that we should be able to find someone and hopefully get them started probably around the first of the year, depending on what notice needs to be given for them. We've also had a van driver resign to take a different position, so we will be hiring a new van driver as well. That will take some time to get on board. There's six trainings that the van drivers need to fulfill before they can start. So we'll start that process as well.
Who was that?
Tom Ryan.
Where's he going?
He has gotten a full-time job closer to his home.
Oh, no.
So,
who's the new one?
Not here.
No, not within
not
here.
Not within
here. No.
Who's the new one?
We don't have a new one yet. We'll be advertising shortly. So, but that will take some time to get in place because there is several things they need to do before they can start. I attended a WRTA quarterly meeting. They meet quarterly and discuss things that are going on within that network of the WRTA. This time they were working on upgrading some of their materials for when people sign up for not what's called non-ADA transportation, which is what we offer here. I attended a MCOA membership meeting on November 20th. And our Aging Mastery, which we were hosting at the library, this is the program that we got a grant for this past year, has completed. So that was a 12-week program. We had about 15 people who made the majority of the sessions. So that has wrapped up at the library. And they will come on Thursday and we'll do a little graduation, give them their certificates. But I think the program overall got a lot of good feedback. And maybe we'll offer it again in the next fall, but maybe here, to try to get a different, you know, group of people. We are working on some manuals for the staff and the volunteers for My Senior Center. My Senior Center is the software that we use to track all our participants. It's the screen that you see when you come in and you use your tag. So to get our receptionists, we've been training our receptionists the last few months on how to use it and how to do different things. But now we have, Dennis is working on written manuals to help people know how to use that or if they get tripped up. I also spoke with the town manager over some of the questions that were raised last meeting by the Council on Aging regarding trip liability for the FASCA trips. I was told that, as I suspected, the FASCA trips are not town trips, so they do not, we do not bear responsibility for liability for those trips. Also, there was a question about the council used to sign warrants some time ago. Under the town charter, the town manager is the one who signs the warrants, and those go in biweekly to her, and she signs off on those. Capital building project updates, the things we have still out there. We're still researching that rear door. We found that one that we wanted, so we have contacted that company, but we don't have a date yet about when that would be installed. We discussed whether we wanted an automatic door back there or we just wanted one that matched the building, and the council voted to have one that just matched the building but didn't feel it needed to be another automatic opener. We're also looking into whether we should replace the door that goes from the front porch to the dining room, because it's starting to fail. The hinges are starting to pull down, and it's been difficult for people to lock up. Also not listed here, the generator work has been done in the last few weeks on that. I believe it's operational now. We haven't got the final word, but they tested it out, and it seems that it is working. We're still researching furniture options, and we're also researching upgrading our alarm to make sure it is working correctly with the changes we've done to the front and reporting to the right person when it goes off. Some upcoming programs we have coming up. We have Stephen Collins. He's an actor, and he will be doing kind of an in-costume Walt Whitman presentation. Walt Whitman was a poet, so he will be acting an evening in Walt Whitman's life. So it's kind of similar to the tea party we had in the fall where the woman came and she was in costume and she talked about the 1800s. Similar kind of thing, but with a male actor talking about Walt Whitman. How to make your home more energy efficient was scheduled for tomorrow, December 9th at 1. We've had no one sign up, so I'm going to cancel that presentation. The FASCA Christmas party is this coming Monday the 14th at 1 o'clock. We've asked people to sign up by today, Tuesday, December 9th. Currently, we have 81 people who have signed up for the party. So there will be music and desserts and Santa Claus, and it should be a nice event. The manicure by Bay Path students, they will be coming December 22nd at 9:30 and 10:30. The signups for those are going well. Each session's about halfway full. There's about 9 people in each so far, so there's still room for people to sign up. Yep.
When they come, are you going to give them any kind of like cookies or some kind of a drink?
Sure.
Right? They've done it in the past.
Yes.
But I wonder if you're still going to do it, just to give them something, yep, in appreciation.
That would be nice to do. We can do that. They do a good job.
They do.
They might be in a different room this coming time, because that is actually the same day as the kitchen's large meal that they're offering. So that they can set up, we might switch some rooms around. And FASCA is also meeting on that day. So we're going to have to take a look and see who we can have where. But you know, the students have limited time when they could be there. And that is the day of the dining room's big meal as well. Few presentations that weren't in the upcoming programs on your sheet that are coming up. Java with Julie's been scheduled for January 11th, which is a Monday at 10 a.m. Java with Julie, when our town manager comes and answers anyone's questions, have a little breakfast. January 11th at 10 o'clock. We also have a representative from Colonial Power, who we discussed a few meetings ago, that the town has gone to this new, what's called energy aggregation program, so that those on NSTAR within the community are going to be switched over to this, you know, municipal aggregation. They can opt out. We're having a representative come and speak about the changes in the end of January. It will be Thursday, January 28th. At 10 o'clock, And that way, people will have received their first bill by then. They should receive their first bill in January. So if they have any additional questions, they can come and speak with the representative right on site here.
I believe it's National Grid, not Insta.
Oh, I'm sorry. National Grid. Thank you, Gene. Also, the AARP tax program, we've been in contact with them, and they will be returning this year. They will be here on the same schedule they were here last year on Mondays, starting February 8th, I believe, will be their first day. That's the second Monday in February. And they will start taking appointments for that the beginning of January. So it will go out in the newsletter that they will be here, what to bring with you to your appointment, and we'll start taking those appointments for people the first week in January, for them starting in February. That's my director's report,
Lillian.
Nothing too exciting to report on the budget. We're pretty much on schedule. One expense that is coming up that we will decide where we should come from is the alarm upgrades. We'll take a look and see if we can pay any of that out of the capital or where we'll be purchasing that from. Happy to answer any other questions if there are any.
Any other concerns?
I have one question. On the budget we have in here, my senior center is $1,200. What did we get for that?
That's the service plan for my senior center.
Service.
So that includes any, it's kind of the maintenance fee that's a yearly fee. So there's a startup cost to buy the software in the beginning, and then this is the yearly fee for them. So it includes all of their upgrades that they're constantly doing and keeping the service up.
Is that linked in with other services, with other centers also?
They cover a lot of senior centers in Massachusetts, several of the ones in the area. It's not linked directly to them. So from our system, we can't look and see, for example, Worcester's numbers.
No, I understand you have an attendee from another senior center, could they sign in here?
They should be able to use their card here, and if you find someone who isn't, it's a setting that we can change. So we can choose whether we want to just accept cards, our cards, or whether we want to accept cards. The downside is if you accept a card from another center, you don't end up with the information on them. So you don't know, you get the attendance, it will show that they attended that program, but it won't tell you what their phone number is or what their address is.
Well,
won't
I don't think you have
that.
To know that, but you have to know what senior center is from.
I don't know if it will tell us what senior center
well,
is from.
Well, they have the information.
Yeah, I mean, it would scan that person attended that program.
Yeah.
But for example, if we needed to cancel a program or do a call or anything or let them know that something's changed, and it wouldn't show us that information.
Right.
It can be worked either way. And there's also a guest button on there so that if someone doesn't have a card and isn't interested in getting a card, we certainly encourage people to, but they can sign in that way too. So they don't have to give us their
personal. Well, I was wondering, because you get ahead of you, we've had some survey results where we had nobody sign in, but we had several surveys, so I was wondering how that worked.
Yeah, I don't think that would have been from them having a card from another center, but it certainly, you know, we encourage everyone to sign in, but often people will come in. They might come through the back door and not come and sign in at the, or they might be running late and they come in. So they're, you know, it is important for everyone, if they can, to sign in, because that's the way we say, we've had this many people come for this program, this is working really well, or we didn't have a lot of people. And when you see, sometimes it can be a great discrepancy of who actually attends and how many actually scan in.
Could you have somebody go in after the meeting and have them sign if they didn't?
Yeah.
And announce it?
Yeah, we can
they
certainly.
They need to sign it to make sure that we have the proper attendance.
Why don't you put it on the questionnaire?
Well, the good thing about the questionnaire, too, is that that's a way for us to reconcile those numbers. Because if we get, you know, only 5 people who sign in, but we get 10 surveys, we can manually add guests. So that wouldn't tell us exactly who was there, but at least it'd give us a better count of who was there. I did want to...
I'll call you back.
So sorry, I'm scooting back to other concerns. I did want to update you on the writing letters to soldiers program with RSVP that we had been speaking about. They've done that for, I believe it's 3 months now. The attendance has been very low. It's only been 2 or 3 people. So I spoke with them this time they were here, and we're going to suspend that program after January. After December. We had put in December's in the newsletter already, so they will come and do December's, but then it just doesn't make sense for us to hold the room or for them to...
What program?
The RSVP writing letters to soldiers.
Yeah, I had that done.
Yeah.
I was going to answer
that. It's going to be suspended.
So December will be the last one. We had already advertised that, so they will come and do that. But from then on, we will take it off the schedule. And it was mentioned at the last meeting, too, about the card players being a little smushed in the room next door.
Mm-hmm.
So we have made a change that we've moved the card players into this room, and we've moved the exercise room class that was here into that room. And Joyce can speak to it, but I believe it's going much better.
Oh, yeah. Much, much better.
Yeah.
A lot more room.
Good. So that seems to, that's keeping...
You happy with that?
Yep. Yeah.
Good.
Thank you. So that allows the movie to keep...
Right.
With the TV and still give everyone the space they need.
Okay. Work group reports, newsletter.
Newsletter. As most of you know, I've been doing the newsletter since Christina Silke left. I found the director. How many years ago was that, Cheryl?
4 or 5? 4 years ago?
Sounds like
at least four. I've been here since year August.
We had another person before.
And then Maria's here a year.
Mm-hmm. 5 or 6.
No, Cheryl before that.
Yeah, and
then Cheryl again.
So what's up?
So I've had to do the newsletter with Cheryl for a whole year without no directors here. And as editor of the Flagtown Flyer, I wanted to let you folks know that the December issue for me was the most challenging. And I'd be remiss if I did not thank Mignon and Cheryl Westerman for resolving the issues. Thank you.
Anything else, Bob?
Nope.
You gave the update on furniture.
Well, to flesh it out a little more, just to recap what we're looking at, we're researching prices and quotes for 2 tables that the ones on the ends are sitting at, so we're getting a couple extra quotes for those. Some stacking chairs with arms to replace the ones that are failing in the next room. And we also, probably before the next meeting, we'll look into purchasing some furniture for the new office for the new staff member, as well as some replacement chairs for those that we need in the front area, as well as some of those plastic mats that go under the chairs to protect the carpet. Because we have new carpet in the front area, and we need one of those under that chair. So we hope to next month bring you, in addition to the card tables that we discussed last time, that we have that type. So we're working on getting those quotes in that list, and hope that we'll have it in time for the next meeting.
Excuse me, what new office?
I'm sorry?
What new office?
The one right outside my office. There's a new little office there that was created. That will be the new outreach coordinator's office.
Oh, what about the old one?
There's 2 now, and they'll be here sometimes on the same day.
Thought it was going to be here on different days.
This will allow us to have 5 days of coverage instead of 3, but they will overlap.
Overlap.
So that space will be for them.
Okay, event protocol. I put this on because there was a problem at the last event, and I would like to have, you and Cheryl and myself sit down and do a protocol on what we're supposed to be doing and mentioning all the names of all the people involved. And I thank all the Council on Aging for all their work that they have done. And that should have been mentioned, and it wasn't. So, thank you all. Is that okay?
Of course it's okay.
So we can set up a time to do that. miscellaneous is about the books. What's happening about the books?
So we've removed the extra books as was asked, and gone to mostly on the shelves. Are there additional problems with the library that we need to think about?
We did.
I mean, we've put books out for free before, and they don't even necessarily go for free. I can certainly bring up the next FASCA. I'm remiss, I haven't brought that up at FASCA yet. They would need to be the ones to sell them about whether we want to have a book sale. But we do have some, you know, we have gotten rid of the extra here, and we have put some out for free for people to take.
What we have, couldn't we donate them to the library when they have their book sale?
We could. I think we brought that up and said, well, why do we want to, you know, if we could sell them ourselves,
we
want to.
We won't.
So let's, I'll bring it up at FASCA next time and see what they think. Parent teacher organization.
The PTO.
When did we have that event?
We haven't. That's the PTO, which is the parent teacher organization in town, has come to us wanting to do an intergenerational event the week of the kids have school, the last week of December. So I've spoken with the card groups that meet before it and the card groups that meet after it, and we found a window of Wednesday, December 30th at 4 o'clock, and they would like to come and do a bingo. So the kids would be invited, the seniors would be invited, the parents would be there, of course. They would provide all of the prizes for the bingo, and I asked FASCA's permission for them to use FASCA papers and the software to run the bingo game. So they had a meeting, the PTO, last night, where they wanted to discuss the details and confirm it. So I haven't heard from them yet this morning to see if that's okay. Once it is, then we will advertise it quickly as it's coming up. But they had their meeting last night, and they were going to discuss that to make sure that's something they wanted to do.
So was that the day that you wanted me to have pitch around start at 12:30?
Yeah, so we're going to...
So that we could break early?
Yeah. So I should know later today, Joyce, if it's a go and if the PTO has decided they would like to do that.
What age group for the children?
You know, I think I asked them, and I want to say that it was like K through 5 was the main group that they were looking at. And they have other events planned that week, so it's hard to know how big or how small it would be. But, I thought it was lovely they wanted to come over and do something together, so hopefully it will work out.
And you said what, 4 o'clock? Isn't there kind of, I don't want to be.
I know. Well, we went through.
Pregnant, but the seniors have this little thing that gets dark. They don't want to go out at night.
Yeah.
And
I know. We went through several different scenarios of days and times to try to get one that fit better. That was the one that we could get to work with our room and our schedule and their schedule. So we'll see.
Right.
Some, if we get a group at all that wants to come out and enjoy it, I think it's great.
Was there a bus for that night?
It does not, no.
So, in other words, you couldn't plan to pick up people at 3:30 or something like that, bring them home at 6 or something like that?
No. Yeah, it's, it will be dark, it will be winter, it could be snowy, we'll have to see. But I didn't want to, I think it was nice Olive Branch to want to do something together, so it's certainly worth a try.
Is there anything else on the miscellaneous? Citizens' comments, anything?
I have a comment. We have a condition outside of that back door that should be taken care of before the snow and ice come down. When they put the threshold in, they chopped the walkway. So there's a space about this wide there that's going to fill up with water and freeze. If that gets under that threshold, it's going to cause a problem with that back door.
Okay.
So it's something that should be taken care of before the weather gets bad.
I have spoken to them about that because there is a spot that's bigger. Their response to me, and I'll certainly readdress it with them, but their initial response was because they've now created the roof and the sides, their hope is that water will not get in there as much as it had done. that was their professional opinion on it. But I will readdress it.
I don't see how the, even the roof is going to make. This is, the sidewalk is here.
Yeah.
You've got a space about an inch and a half wide that's empty. And then you've got the threshold over here. This has to be filled in before the snow and ice come.
I'll readdress it with
Because that's going to get underneath that threshold. It's going to cause a problem with that door.
Yeah.
And there are a lot of from the village that use that door, myself included.
Yeah.
When we walk down, we don't want to have to, in the wintertime, walk all the way around because the door's not working.
Sure. Of course, it's a brand new door. It's a brand new slab. And they have put the roof to keep the snow away and the sides. But I will readdress it with them. But that was their response when I did ask about it.
I don't know why they didn't fix it when they put the thing in, when they put the door in. They could have seen that.
Yeah. Well, they did see it. They feel as if the sides and the roof will not create the water in there. But I'll readdress it with them and see if we can get a solution.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Anything else? I need a motion.
I have one more thing I'd like to say. It's actually to Bob. I know that you do a wonderful job with this. It's a lot of work, and I myself appreciate all that you do, and I just want to thank you for it.
Thank you.
We all do.
We all do.
Yeah.
Thank
you,
Bob. Okay, anything else? I need a motion to adjourn.
I make a motion to adjourn this meeting.
I second it.